My dear friends, this is Abraham talking to you all the way from India. Well, you may be in any part of the world, in any country, but India is the headline news on your television, on your news channel. Because as you know, that we are facing the biggest crisis ever any country has ever seen. It almost looks like the pandemic, the coronavirus, has been dumped into India. Would you believe that 390,000 cases every day? Every day. That is not, may not be the realistic data, because I don't know whether, where, how will you be able to find the numbers from the remote villages, almost 600,000 villages in the nation of India. And even this number is too high. And what are we facing? People are not able to help. I'm living in the capital city of Delhi. And what about us? There is no oxygen cylinder in any hospital. People are dying in the rickshaws, in the taxis, on the road, because they can't breathe. Can you imagine that? The free oxygen that our God, the Maker, has given, become so precious. People are saying, I can't breathe, and they die. There's no beds in the hospital. People are dying all over the place. So the dead bodies are taken to the cemetery, and they're saying there's no place here. Dead bodies are lined up. There's no place to bury them. And in the cremation grounds, there's mass cremation going on, because there's no place to cremate. The incinerator is packing up because too many dead bodies to burn. The saddest thing is, I lost 5 of my own pastors to COVID. Amazing men, dedicated servants of God. They died just like that. They died within 2-3 days, they were gone. We just buried on Sunday one of my pastor's wife, 38 years old. Another pastor's son on Monday, 27 years old. I'm getting SOS calls from my pastors. Emergency, every call is an emergency. Somebody wants to bury the dead, they can't even buy their coffin. Somebody's wanting money because they cannot go to the hospital because they can't pay the bills. Calls to buy the coffin, the needs. Where will I go? We are trying to send all the money we can find. Putting my hands up in the air, saying, God, God, how can I handle this? How can we take care of these people? I'm coming to you, my dear friends. Blatantly, I'm asking you 2 things from you. But we want all the prayers we can find from you. Pray for us. We need every prayer we can find. And the second one is, we need finance. Now. We can't wait for another month, another 2 months. No, friends, we need our finance now to take care of these people who are in need. Please help us. Please help us to reach the lost. Medicines, a burial, oxygen. Help us. God will richly bless you.